How you doing, everybody? This is Michael and Jeffrey's Top 10, May the 4th edition. How you doing?
I'm so excited. I love Star Wars, dude.
Star Wars is the best. Always. This is May. We got May the 4th coming up. So this is going to be our May the 4th edition, May the 4th episode. We're going to go with the top 10 Star Wars movies.
Theatrical
movies. My name is Michael.
I'm Jeffrey.
Today we have another guest. We have Emily here with us in the studio. Say hi, Emily.
Hi, guys.
And she's going to go ahead and help us out with our top 10 countdown on Star Wars movies. Nice. Great time.
You must feel the force around you.
We're going to have a lot of fun today. We're going to talk about...
Father.
We're going to talk about the movie. So there are 12 movies in the Star Wars franchise. I mean, we're top 10, so we're just going to go with top 10. Why not? We're going to have a lot of repeats, but we're going to have a lot of fun, guys. You have anything to...
There's 12?
There's 12.
Rogue One.
It was 11.
Han Solo. Yes. What's the other one?
And Clone Wars. It's a movie. It was theatrically released.
Was it really?
Yes, it was. Oh, the Clone Wars. Yeah.
I didn't. Mm-hmm. No.
How dare you guys? I'm sorry.
Where's tea when you need them?
I'm sorry. I'm sorry about that, guys. We have a couple.
What?
And
Yes.
I'm really not sure where all of these sounds are, guys. So they're just gonna kind of be, you know.
Never tell me the odds.
Never. Mm-hmm. Never do it. Mm-hmm. All right. So, Jeffrey, do you have any announcements today?
Yeah. We are featuring, again, 5 years later with their new song. Not new song. New song.
This isn't their song.
Yeah. But they would love to play that song.
I'm sure they would.
We'll feature them at the halftime show.
All right.
5 years later.
5 years later. Halftime show. They'll be there. And we'll be here. All right. So, without further ado.
Don't forget, we release every Wednesday, Michael.
Yes.
We keep forgetting to tell people that
we're released every Wednesday at midnight. Right?
Would that be...
If you're, got some time, it's 12 a.m. and you don't know what to do, just know that Michael and Jeffrey's top 10 is right there.
Yeah. We'll put you right to sleep.
Jeez. So without further ado, we're going to go ahead and jump right in. We'll let the ladies go first in this episode because we're gentlemen.
Okay.
All right.
So my 10 was The Force Awakens.
That was also my 10.
That's your 10?
Yes. Yeah.
Wow.
10.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I'm going to say that was my number 7. Just because.
What? Yeah. You had three other movies in front of The Force Awakens? Seriously? I love Star Wars. I love all Star Wars movies. I've watched all Star Wars movies in theaters except for Solo.
Okay. Not missing much.
Not a big fan. I wasn't rushing to the theater for that one. But I watched all theatrical movies, even the ones that came out in the 90s, the older ones. The original three came out in the 90s. My parents took us all to go to the movies to watch those, so lucky to do that. But Force Awakens, number 10.
Yeah, it just was not very memorable.
Yeah.
But it was like exciting because it was the first Star Wars movie that I had seen in
a very long time.
The theaters.
Jeffrey looks like he begs to differ. What's up, Jeffrey? What you got over there, dude?
I mean, it was fine. It was better than I thought the other two that came after it. So we'll go over the other two when I'll tear them a new one. Don't all you right. worry.
So in the number in The Force Awakens, we find out that there's this girl Rey. She's stranded in the desert. Which desert was she at, Jeffrey?
Jakku.
She was stranded in the old desecrated battlegrounds of Jakku. Mm-hmm. And she was left there by somebody. We don't know who in this movie. But she was just left there. Mm-hmm. Stranded. And her name is Rey, like I said. It seems as if she is force sensitive, right? In the very beginning of the movie. You know, you could tell who the Jedi is gonna be.
Yeah. I mean, she's practically dressed already. Jedi.
I know. Bro, I thought she was gonna be friggin' Obi-Wan's.
Yeah, that's what we ancestor. All thought. Yeah, that could have gone so many ways.
Dude, they threw a fat curveball into that one. But we'll talk about that later. but yeah, what's your favorite part in that movie, Emily?
My favorite part? I can't tell you. Okay.
The best part in that movie is when it's terrible, but when Kylo Ren kills Han Solo. Spoiler alert.
Spoiler.
It's full of spoilers.
Oh my God.
That was your favorite part.
That was like terrible, but
never tell me the odds.
But rememberable. Rememberable.
It was terrible. But yeah, that was really like the only part where I was like,
I definitely thought he was coming back.
I
really did.
When I saw him right there in that little like scene, I knew. When that little scene started happening, I knew. This fucker's gonna kill this guy.
Yeah.
And then how he was talking to him too, like, I need you to help me do something that I can't. I just can't do by myself.
See, that's what kind of killed it for me. He's just being a little wimpy. A
little bitch.
Yeah.
But Anakin was a little bitch too sometimes. Mm-hmm. You know, so he got it. He got it from his grandpa.
Skip the generation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, yeah, all right, number 10. That's our number 10. What's your number 10, Jeffrey?
My number 10 is number 8, The Last Jedi.
Oh, I like The Last Jedi.
You like The Last Jedi?
I mean, it was better than The Force Awakens for me.
No, it was... Luke was not what we were expecting. He's being like, oh, I don't want to train you. Oh, the Jedi's got to end, blah, blah, blah. Were you guys expecting that? No.
Yeah, it didn't make my list.
It didn't even make your
The Last Jedi. There's 12 movies. The Last Jedi did not make
she put Han Solo.
The Last Jedi was number 8 for me. Okay.
Yeah. The only good thing about that movie.
I must obey my master.
Was the porks, and the blue milk.
Oh God!
When Luke just takes a big swig of it.
Oh wait. Oh, that's the wrong.
Hey. Jabba was not in that one. He was already dead.
He was already
dead. Oh, wow. Spoiler.
Spoiler.
So, when I say it's my top 10, that means it's bad. We got to remember we're only working with 12.
Yeah.
So, this is on the
that's
the worst end. So, we should be talking about what's bad about these movies.
What's bad about them is that why did he just fucking burn the tree?
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. All the Jedi knowledge.
Come on, dude. Come on, Yoda.
Up in flames.
I totally thought they were going to go the great Jedi route.
It's why you fail. Like,
they were going to go that route, and they totally didn't. It was quite disappointing. I thought like Qui-Gon was gonna come back, be like, no, this is the right way.
That would have been great.
Yeah
would have, but it wasn't.
It was just a lot of like loose ends that just stayed loose.
Who the fuck is Finn? Yeah. Why? Like, yeah. Is he force sensitive? Is he?
See, that was the movie.
I mean, he wielded a
light. I thought you had to be. Like, well, I guess Han Solo wielded a lightsaber because he cut open the what's that called?
Tauntaun.
The Tauntaun. To help Luke.
Okay.
So I'm pretty sure anybody could wield a lightsaber, but only a force sensitive person or a Jedi or somebody that knows the Force can create a lightsaber, right? Is that accurate?
Oh, I don't know if that's accurate.
Because don't they have to, like, don't they create it? Like,
I'm sure someone with hands could just
put it together.
Yeah, put it together.
Break it apart, put it together. Weld it.
Yeah.
It was an episode in The Clone Wars.
In The Clone Wars. Yeah, he's a robot.
Is it a robot?
Or a droid.
It was a droid that was like, you guys got to do this, blah, blah, blah.
Oh. Mm.
I don't know if he actually put any together, though.
Yeah, because the only one that I saw get put together was the girl or the guy put it together with the Force.
Mm.
So.
Mm.
They were just showing off their powers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Look what I could do.
But yeah, number 8.
No, that was number 10.
No. Well, I'm sorry.
Number 8, the movie.
Yeah.
Number 8,
Last Jedi.
That's the one where they go to like the gambling planet.
Yeah, what the fuck was that?
Literally nothing came from that.
Yeah.
Yeah, didn't they go there to meet the guy and then didn't help him.
Yeah, he didn't help him.
He fucked him over.
And that's how it ended.
And that's it. Like, they made Captain Phasma look like a bitch.
Yeah, yeah. Total whiff the whole.
Yeah. 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 I don't understand that.
And then at the end, they show like the little kid that like Force brings the broom to him.
Oh, yeah. And then it's nothing. Like, what? Then nothing after that? Nothing. Like, I don't know why.
Well, I think there was two ways they're going with that. They're like, oh, anyone could be Force sensitive, everyone could be a Jedi. Or the resistance was rising because, you know, the Force is coming back. It was a mess. It was a hot mess.
Destiny.
What else happened in that movie? It was that, and then that was it.
Rose's sister was killed in the very first couple of minutes.
Oh, and that was cool.
Yeah,
that was the bonus. All of the shitty parts.
That was the best part. Because
when she dies, yeah.
It was
destiny
that she had.
Yeah, she had to kick. See, I don't know if kicking that stuff would actually done it.
No,
it was like why did the thing fall if they were in space?
Right,
they got gravity in there.
Okay, and that was the same one where everyone in the like control room
wasn't it open or something?
Yeah,
right.
Yeah, mm-hmm.
It had already like exploded and shit.
And tell me this, why do bombs, so that it was a bomber,
mm-hmm.
They're in space.
They just why are bombs down. Going
straight down?
Yeah. Don't they just.
They're mechanisms that we know nothing about.
Yeah, well,
okay.
Jedi scum.
Can't wait to get there because it did not make any sense.
But all right. That was number 10 for Jeffrey.
Yeah, my top 10.
My bottom 10.
All right, number 9, The Phantom Menace.
Hey, same.
Yeah.
Ooh. Same.
That's my number 5.
Oh God!
This should be higher on your list, Michael, because this is the first one that came out in theaters when we were kids. Has to be.
No, actually, the first one that came out in theaters when we were kids was A New Hope in the 1990s.
Did they re-release it? Because that movie came out.
They re-released it with new like little parts in it.
Oh. Because that was originally released in like the 70s.
Yeah. Yes, I know.
Michael?
Okay, but The Phantom Menace, Emily and I's number 9. Jeffrey's number 5.
My number 5.
It was cool. It was cool. It was a cool movie, but all the other movies were better. Maybe not The Last Jedi. I should probably have The Last Jedi one.
Yeah, thank you.
One. That's true. So we'll change it up. Number 8. Anyways, The Phantom Menace, Darth Maul, first came out. He was a badass.
He's the best part of that movie.
Yep. He's a badass fucking
Him and Qui-Gon.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. The ones who died.
Yeah.
Well, we thought that Maul died.
Yeah.
But he didn't. Spoiler alert. Wow.
Spoiler did he get cut in half?
How the fuck did he survive?
He went down that big ass hole? Weird.
No. But yeah, fucking, what was your like favorite part in that movie?
Oh, the pod racing.
Yeah, me too.
Obviously.
Now this is pod racing.
Yeah. Well, oh well, throwback to fucking
the pod racing. The pod racing. Pod racing game.
Yeah, like this was the best part of that whole movie when he races and he beats the Bulba and fucking
How like, dare you?
He your Jedi mind tricks don't work on me. Yeah. And yeah.
And Jar Jar, I mean, we can't forget about Jar Jar.
Misa Jar Jar Binks.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm. You know why it's my number five? The final battle.
That's a badass final battle.
The music, that music is the dual fates.
Yeah.
Best battle music, I thought, in Star Wars.
Yeah, it's good.
It's good. It's really good.
That's why it's higher up on my list.
Just that one.
Mm-hmm. Oh, that battle.
Da-na-na-na-na. Da-na-na-na. Wait.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's the one,
that's
right?
That's it. Yep. And then, ooh, fireworks.
Ooh.
And also, this was the first movie for me. It's called Star Wars. You gotta admit, like, the other four, five, and six didn't really feel war-y. This one felt like a Star Wars.
Are you serious? You're with
Phantom Menace?
You're with this guy? four, five, and six didn't... Bro, it was nothing but... Star Wars. It was nothing but
more like Star Battles.
Oh,
wait,
but we'll get back to that.
Bro, they were in
what part
space.
Of it
they
was
were,
a war,
bro,
though?
In A New Hope when they fucking got the Death Star.
Yeah, but that's okay. You gotta
they
think
were
of
in
a,
space.
You gotta think of a scale. It was like 12 fighters against a Death Star.
Yeah, the Death Star blew up an entire planet, though.
Yeah,
but. Do you guys know what war is? Have you guys seen Saving Private Ryan? Like, it's people fighting each other, like an actual war, like hundreds of people on screen.
Bro,
but you did not see
Return of the Jedi.
Yeah,
with the Ewoks,
they were on the they were okay. on the ground.
Yeah, yeah. I've seen
that.
War.
That did not feel like that felt like a battle, not a war, guys. I don't know what to tell you.
Wait, which part of it seemed like a war, though?
We had the final battle with the Gungans and the droids. They lined up literally like Civil War style. They're just, all right, let's line up and just shoot a bunch of lasers at each other. Just saying, you didn't get that really in the other three.
So it was the Gungans for you.
No, it was the droids. Droid's best character.
Hey,
Roger, Roger.
Roger, Roger. Roger.
Hey, what's happening over there?
Fun fact: did you know that the droids can feel pain?
Really?
Yeah.
That would make sense when
let that sit. The droids feel pain. That's why they're all like,
do they feel pain, or have they been programmed to react like they're feeling pain?
I mean, isn't that the same?
No.
To feel like they're feeling pain.
They think they're feeling pain.
Yeah, but they're, I'm sure they feel it.
I mean, we don't know.
Chicken or the egg?
That isn't...
Well, that's a debatable fact. Well,
interesting thought, though.
What?
But yeah, my number that was my number five. Sorry, guys.
Anyways. All right, well, Phantom Menace. We could talk about it later.
Yeah.
We don't have to.
I feel like we do, though.
I'd rather not. All right, number nine, Jeff, what you got?
My number nine is number nine. The something Skywalker.
The right. Rise,
the
of,
Rise
Skywalker?
Of Skywalker?
You have that at number nine?
That was a hot mess, too.
That's my eight.
Really?
That's a hot mess, too.
I liked that one.
What? What did you like about that one?
That's the ending.
The ending.
Bro, it all came together. Like, it all came together. We could talk about it a little later.
Really?
I got a little higher on my list.
Okay.
Well, I'm going to talk bad about it. And you can talk all your good about it. Final Emperor Palpatine comes back.
Out of freaking nowhere.
What happened to what's his face? What was the other bad guy's name?
Snoke.
Yeah.
Snoke.
He just.
What do you mean?
Snoke. Kylo cut him in half.
Kylo cut him in half, bro.
Straight up.
Yeah. He was like, oh, I'm the. He was made in the seventh episode.
But it wasn't Snoke.
Mm.
It was Palpatine, bro.
Lame.
They never said that.
Yes, they did.
Mm.
He said at the end when he was like, I'm all the voices in your head, blah, blah, blah. He was saying that it was him. I'm all these people. Blah. He created him. He did all this shit.
There were clones of Snoke in the beginning of 9. But anyways, he was supposed to be a big bad guy. We didn't need Palpatine. He was done.
And it's the Skywalker saga. Of course you needed Palpatine.
No, you don't.
To end it.
He could fight other people.
Who?
Snoke. The real Snoke.
Yeah.
Let's see. What else? The final battle, it was atrocious. Horses in space.
Yeah, no, that was...
And then literally all these ships come out of nowhere.
It was
Marvel
more,
style.
It was...
Yes.
Endgame style.
It was more the nostalgic feeling that I got.
Okay.
When like it was all like happening at the end and a Skywalker did save and did sacrifice and it was just it just all came together well. The ending came together well. The beginning the whole movie it was good, but I think it was more like the climax and the big, the big battle at the end, and it's Palpatine and Ben came back and
no one.
I was like,
Did you like Ben as a character?
Yes.
Oh,
yeah.
Ben Swallow, huh? He loved him.
Ben Swallow.
Yeah, he was just. I don't know.
He was just so torn. He was so torn.
Like the whole Darth Vader thing. He didn't bring him up afterwards. Like,
oh
ever
yeah,
again.
Him praying to his
dad,
helmet.
His grandpa. Yeah, that didn't come back.
Did anyone ever tell him that he did turn back to the light before he died?
Rey knew.
Yeah, but right, remember? Did Ben know?
Yeah. I don't think so.
I guess.
He's like asking him to give him strength. I'm like,
he found out at the end of the 9th movie.
He's like, Grandpa?
Uh-huh.
And then the ending, and you like, she's like, Rey Skywalker. Come on. You can't tell me you like that. You can't tell me.
So lame.
It was the last Skywalker.
Oh my god, he loves it.
It all came together.
All right, well, I'm gonna keep trashing it all day. So,
destiny.
All right, yeah. that was your number 9.
That was my number 9. Yes.
Yeah, my number 8 was what was it? What's your number 8? Emily.
Mine's Rise of Skywalker.
Yeah, The Last Jedi. Yeah. All right. Well, number 7. Emily, what's your number 7?
A New Hope.
Me too.
Dang. You guys did not like that one. Huh?
Where do you have A New Hope?
My New Hope is 4.
Huh. Hmm. All right.
Mm-hmm.
All right. That's where I have Rise of Skywalker. Nostalgic. Yeah. We talked about it already.
You put the original.
Yeah.
You know
it's
what?
The nostalgia of it, but the original is way behind.
You know what? I feel bad now. I think I'm gonna move that to seven. I think Michael's gonna have to. This is our show. I can do whatever I want. So I'm gonna move it to number seven, and I'll let you guys talk about your number. Well, what's your number seven, Jeffrey?
Mine was. I forgot. What's number seven called again?
Force Awakens.
Force Awakens.
Oh, okay.
Well, we already talked about it, but I mean, that one, it was an okay start to, like, coming after Return of the Jedi. It's just the way they followed up kind of brought this movie down, I thought.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. And then how Finn just, like, hurt Kylo Ren. Doesn't make any goddamn sense.
Yeah. Who's like super powerful. Yeah. Training, like, for years.
Like, what? What kind of pussy is this guy? But yeah. All right. Yeah. You guys, it's May the 4th episode. I should have thought about this sooner. Yeah, but we'll talk about A New Hope right now. A New Hope. Emily, talk about it.
Yeah. Well, it's obviously a classic, so I like it for that because it was the first one, but it wasn't as exciting as I felt like some of the other movies were.
No, I would say it's probably the least exciting movie, for sure.
Yeah, so there were really good parts of it.
Good intro movie, you know?
But it was just kind of...
blah.
Yeah.
Makes sense.
Yeah.
What have I done?
The first half of that movie was pretty slow. Yeah. The whole Tatooine thing.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We usually just make fun of Luke whining all the time.
But the cool part is when fucking his aunt and uncle are all burned up.
They're just bones on the floor.
They threw a skeleton out there and called it done. Yeah.
You know who that is. Yeah. I'd be on the floor. They really fucking goddamn.
Yeah, he really didn't have too many emotions connected to that.
Yeah. And, to anything, really.
Really?
Except his dad, he didn't know about.
Yeah. Like,
he's got daddy issues. That's right. I know a couple maneuvers. But yeah, New Hope.
It was higher up on my list. The Death Star trench run was pretty iconic for me.
Yeah, come on, Darth Vader, fucking
I have you now.
Yeah. Spinning out.
Yeah.
Super, like, it's just his helmet, so it's like super straight face. Yes.
Yeah.
Here he came.
Yeah.
Freaking. We met Darth Vader for the first time. Let's just revel.
Yeah. That's good.
It's, come on. Yeah. That's one of the best villain songs.
It's amazing.
Ever.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
We saw Darth Vader. I remember looking at it, there was nothing like him.
That's true.
Who was like him? Who was like Darth Vader? Mm. Got you and he fucking choked you with invisible hand. His invisible hand. It was there, but nothing was touching him and he was choking him. Mm-hmm. What?
Do you think it's more menacing if you did it with his real hand, though? I feel like that's more personal when you choke someone with your
I think the fear of it happening at any point would be the biggest factor.
Yes.
But you gotta admit, though, that fight scene with him and Obi-Wan, it was pretty trash.
Pretty lame.
It was literally two old guys.
One swipe.
We're going at it. But
yeah, just, yeah, two old guys going at it.
Yeah.
Yeah. Mm. What do you mean?
But yeah, very anticlimactic fight.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But, well, I mean, I was going to say, look what they had back then, but come on, Empire's like, we'll talk about Empire a little later.
Yeah, that was good.
Mm-hmm. We'll talk about that a little later. but yeah, New Hope, it was good. You know, good intro. Nice to see all the characters, you know, come in. Very iconic. Very first Star Wars. 70s.
Mm-hmm.
76, 77, something like that. Or is it like 79?
76 sounds right.
Yeah. I don't know.
Some.
But yeah. That bumped up to my number six.
That's your six?
That's my six now because I changed it. Because I felt bad. So what's your number six, Emily?
Return of the Jedi.
Wow.
You have it that high.
Oh, what do you have up there?
Oh my God. What the hell?
That's my number two.
For real, that's my number three. Yeah. Jeez.
Why is it so low?
You can talk about the bad. We'll talk about the good later. Okay.
Well, the bad part that I don't quite understand is how the Ewoks were able to take out the whole Empire.
Destiny. Duh.
Yeah, I just don't see it. They're a bunch of little like teddy bears that have sticks.
Yeah, but they made them.
I mean, you saw the movie.
Yeah, they fucked them up with logs.
Yeah, logs.
Big ass logs. How the fuck did they move those logs?
Those little guys.
Like, they already had the logs in place.
That was their trap. You would think the Empire would be like, huh, there's a lot of logs up there. There's a lot of motion going on over there.
Look at all those logs.
Yeah, it just, it was, yeah.
God, rough. That's not enough. Just the Ewoks? Really?
Yeah, the Ewoks, it just threw me. It just seemed like this is how this saga is going to end. But then looking at how the newest one ended, I guess it kind of makes sense.
I don't know. Yeah. Was there a number count? There's probably like hundreds of Ewoks, and there was probably only like 50 stormtroopers. Like I mean,
there was only 50 stormtroopers at that base.
I think there was way more than 50 because when they came out and they brought them out and they were like right there or whatever, the Ewoks surrounded them or whatever, and then like Han Solo's like, oh, I don't know. What happened? like fuck, there was a shitload of them right there.
Yeah, I don't know. And then like in the new, when they re-released it, they showed like AT-AT walkers in the background. Was not in the movie. There was no walk like those walkers.
It was just that one walker.
The AT-STs, yeah. That was it. That got fucked up by logs. So, but I think it was...
They had AT-ATs in the newer one that came out? In the like remake?
Yeah, in the re-release. You saw them in the background. It was when... Luke and Darth Vader were going up to Death Star. AT-ATs.
Yeah. Okay.
That makes it even less believable.
I think it was part of
that. Actually, does
kind these of these Ewoks like, just destroyed an AT-AT
with logs? Yeah. Hey,
what were they? They were sleeping.
Yeah. I honestly don't remember what else happened in that movie besides the beginning.
Oh, we'll talk about it later. I mean, don't you worry.
Okay.
The ending? Oh my God.
The ending is the best part.
Of that movie?
Yes.
Okay.
Oh my gosh.
If you say so.
All right. Well, that was your number
six,
right? Yeah.
Yes.
You, Jeffrey, your number six?
My number six was Revenge of the Sith.
What?
My bad one is fucking okay. I putting the Rise of Skywalker up. I moved that. I moved it back because I got it. I understood why. But you have Revenge of the Sith at number 6?
Yeah.
That's my number 2, bro.
You know what? I just didn't like when I first watched it.
Oh my god.
I did not like Anakin as a character.
Oh my god.
I think that's the point.
Well, I meant like
I must obey
not,
my
not him
master.
As an evil person, but he was just annoying.
What do you mean?
Like Luke?
Yeah. But worse.
What have I done?
It was worse. look at these quotes. This is like seeing him acting like that. Like, I don't know. It was bad.
The thing I give to Anakin is he acts like a little bitch sometimes. But that's his whole MO, bro. He's an emo. He's an emo kid.
Yeah.
Revenge of the Sith, I think, was so good.
Now that I think about it should better. Be higher than A New Hope, which is my number 5.
Yeah.
But I would move it maybe up one more. Maybe. Maybe.
So you like the Obi-Wan and Darth Maul fight, but you don't like the Obi-Wan and Anakin fight in that movie?
Oh my god.
That,
bar none, is the best fucking fight scene in that whole series.
I disagree with that.
Oh my god, please let us know in any fucking comment. <you can.
laughs> I
oh my god.
I don't agree with that.
Oh my god.
It took that fight was so long.
Oh my god.
They went everywhere. I don't know. I just didn't like it.
It's why you fail.
I liked it. Okay, I liked it, but it was not better than the Darth Maul fight.
Oh, come on.
That fight was like 10 seconds long,
bro.
And half of it was them standing in a corridor.
Come on.
No. Did you? I think you need to rewatch that movie. They literally started in the hangar and they move all the way into the
hangar. You're right. I mean, you're right. But it still was probably like, bro, 20 seconds.
They literally start in a hangar and they go through all of this lava and volcanoes and all these fucking shits and end up at the bottom of the fucking volcano next to lava. What do you mean?
It's too much flash. All these things going off is taking away from,
bro,
the actual fight.
Those were the best fighting like scenes, like fighting like lightsaber duels in the whole fucking series. You're crazy.
I'm not saying they're bad. I'm just saying the Darth Maul one was
We'll talk about it later. We'll talk about it later. God damn it. All right, that was your number 6?
Yeah, number 6, Revenge of the Sith. What else do I have to say about this one? There has to be more. The whole thing about Padme dying. How'd she die again? A sadness.
A broken heart, I think.
What the fuck?
You're breaking my heart.
That and probably lack of oxygen.
I think your heart stopped beating.
Yeah. We were introduced to the force choke in that movie, Jeffrey. I just don't understand.
The force choke?
Well, not introduced, but we knew that. It was like the first time we saw Anakin doing.
I'll show you a force choke.
Oh.
That's what she said.
Bruh. So you guys liked, at the end, when he became Vader, his big scream at the end?
No.
No, it didn't sound like that. Do it right. No.
Like the very emotionless.
Where's Padme? I felt her. She was alive. That was corny.
Yeah, I think it could have done without, because it didn't really add anything. It kind of seemed like they were gonna go into Vader being like this like turmoiled person.
Yeah.
And then
kind of took away from that.
But in the first
three movies
that were released, he's not like that at all until the very end.
And
like, you don't ever
see
him waver.
Of the three movies that were released. Mm-hmm. Agree to disagree.
Yeah.
Agree to disagree.
Yep.
Oh, a little heated. Got a little heated, guys. But that'll happen when it comes to Star Wars.
All right. At halftime, we have 5 years later with their song Push. Check it out. And that was Push from 5 years later. Can we get a fun fact?
Fun fact? Let's get a fun fact. Let's get a fun fact. A little slow on the fun fact. Oh,
they are... Well, one of them's Emily's dad, our guest,
huh.
And her two uncles.
That was really fun. Yeah.
Check them out.
Check them out. We're going to have the link in the bio. In the... Ready to go?
Yeah.
We're going to go to number five. My number five. I got Attack of the Clones.
Wait, we skipped my... That was my six.
Oh, that was your six?
Oh. Mm-hmm.
Oh, well.
Oh, well.
Yeah. Jeffrey six, welcome. Our number five. Mm-hmm. We'll get to your number five after this. After these moments of Attack of the Clones.
Attack of the Clones.
Very good movie.
Yeah, I think so. This is the first one that brought, this is the legit one that brought Star Wars. Wars to Star Wars. I will say this one.
Yeah.
The whole fight at the Geonosis.
During the Jedi. Good. Sorry.
No, not Return of the Jedi. as Emily already mentioned, Ewoks against the Empire, not a war. the whole fight scene with the Jedi's coming in.
Yeah, that was
sick.
That was sick. You see Mace Windu come out.
Yeah.
You're like, oh shit.
Yeah.
Motherfucker.
But a lot of them died there. Like, I don't know if you guys remember, there was only like 5 left or 6 left.
Yeah.
I think there was a little more. I think there was like 10.
Okay, well, sure. But I feel like they dropped in like 50 of them.
Yeah, they dropped in a lot.
Yeah. They came out of nowhere. Yeah, it was a lot. So a lot of Jedi died that day.
So did Jango.
So did Jango.
Mm-hmm. Jango.
I think this one was it for the lore sake. I really liked how they brought in the clones.
Yeah.
And how they brought up like how it kind of went into the third one.
Well,
they did a good job.
I never knew who Master Sifo Dyas was.
Oh no,
like right before that, and I was like when we were talking about that. I was like, who the fuck is Master Sifo Dyas? Fuck is this guy? Why don't I fucking know him? But I guess no one else knew who he was. But yeah, like that movie all around was pretty good. I didn't really like the whole Padme Anakin love story kind of thing. It was a little cheesy to me.
A lot of memes came out of that.
Yeah, I've got some funny memes.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Well, just in general on Star Wars.
Sand.
Sand. Oh, yeah, the sand everywhere. Memes.
So coarse. yeah. That was the first half. That was a big portion of it, I think.
What?
Of that movie.
Oh, yeah. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
We could have done without that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
No.
Yeah. But then when Anakin went out to look for his... mom, and he killed them.
Yeah,
but not just the men, but the women
and the children.
There's some funny memes about that one too.
It's okay, Annie. Yeah. you did it already.
Yeah. What's done is done.
It's not like I'm a senator or anything. Jeez. But yeah, fucking the animals are pretty cool.
Mm-hmm.
And then he ended up riding one of those fucking what are they called? The green
hippos.
Ones? No.
Yeah, hippos.
Hip hop. Hip hop anonymous. in another movie, Obi-Wan. But anyways, yeah, it was really cool. I really like the part where they were like going through the factory.
Mm-hmm.
And trying
Kamino,
yeah,
mm-hmm.
And trying to get out of the fucking factory and shit.
That's Geonosis,
is it?
Yeah.
Which factor?
The one where they're building the droids.
Oh yeah, that is Geonosis.
Oh,
yeah.
I'm sorry. Yeah, I was thinking of the clones.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
It was the clones.
Yeah,
that's fine. I don't know. Anyways, yeah, pretty much. If we saw Dooku, fucking. Get down with Yoda at the end. That was pretty.
That was good. That was a good battle.
That was pretty good. Too short.
Yeah.
Too that's short.
First time you saw Yoda fight.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. And I remember.
He jumps all over the place.
He's all over the place.
It's all flash.
You must feel the force around you.
You know what I'm saying?
You must unlearn what you have learned.
That's what he says. Well, no, he doesn't say that to Dooku. But yeah, it was a good. Good movie.
Mm-hmm.
Good movie. Attack of the Clones.
Mm-hmm.
That one came out. I was like, all right, cool. Cool.
Yeah.
Cool. This is Jedi business. Go back to your drinks. All right. But yeah, that was my number 5. That was your number 6, Jeffrey. What's your number 5?
1, 2. We already went over my number 5. That was... Oh, it would be, because I said Return of the Jedi. No, wait, what's 3? That's 3 is Revenge of the Sith, sorry. We already went over it.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. We went over. Now we're at number four, Jeffrey. Emily, what's your number four?
Okay, so this is where most of my movies are based around Darth Vader because I love Darth Vader so much. Like, love it. So,
yes.
Yeah. Anyways, but mine is The Empire Strikes Back for number four.
Wow.
No.
Ooh. Loves Darth Vader, puts in number five.
Puts in number number four.
Okay.
Oh my god. I love Darth Vader. So Empire is number four.
I love it. Okay. Oh, I do. God. I do. But I don't. I like it a lot because I like the AT-ATs, so they're like my favorite out of everything in the Star Wars universe. So the Hoth battle scene is like awesome for me. But that's mainly why I like that movie. As well as Han Solo gets frozen in carbonite. And Darth Vader hosts a dinner party. I love that part. I think it's so funny. He looks like he's like set a table for all of them. And then, yeah, I just.
Now you will die.
I just think it's so funny.
We're going to.
All right.
Whoa. I feel like we should just talk about this one a little.
Oh, yeah, that's going to be. We'll help you out.
Yeah.
Why?
We'll just talk about it a little later. A little.
It's sorry about that. It's higher up. It's higher up on our list.
Oh.
Yeah, it's. Well,
Yeah.
Of course.
Oh yeah, you're not gonna like my number one.
Oh god.
Number one, Han Solo. Loves Darth Vader.
That's two, actually. Oh, no.
Please no.
Yeah,
I know
it is.
Oh my god. All right. Well, we'll go with my number four right now. Yeah, or what's your number four, Jeffrey?
Well, my number four is A New Hope. So we kind of already talked about this.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, we don't need to talk about it at number four.
Yeah. It's, I mean, it was the one that kind of started all for me, but the Death Star scene was my favorite. I mean, in any game that I played, I was like, oh, I want to destroy the Death Star in the trench run.
Aww.
So that's where it falls special in my heart.
Nerd.
Yeah. Yeah.
All right. My number four is Rogue One.
Mm. I love Rogue One.
Do you have Rogue One in your list?
I do.
All right. Do you have Rogue One in your list, Jeff?
My number three.
Okay. The best scene in this whole movie is like 15 seconds long.
You should save that for Emily.
We'll save that for Emily. Oh, yeah. But this is a really good movie.
Mm-hmm.
Very, very good movie. Very in the feels. What's it? Galen Erso? Isn't it Galen Erso? The guy who the
Galen Erso,
the architect of the Death Star.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
He's trying to run away from the Empire,
mm-hmm.
and the Empire find him. What's the
bad guy?
The bad guy,
Krennic.
Yeah,
something Krennic. Like that.
So he's trying to get away from him. He finds him because he has a great mind, and this great mind, like I said, is the architect of the Death Star. He created the Death Star. He takes him. He has a wife and daughter.
Mm-hmm.
What's the daughter's name again? Jin mm-hmm. or so?
Mm-hmm. Jin.
The Krennic, what's it?
Krennic
orders the Death Troopers. Fucking, that was the first time we saw Death Troopers on screen too. That shit was sick.
Yep.
Orders the Death Troopers to kill fucking his wife, and they take him,
mm-hmm.
and they leave the little girl behind, and then it goes to you guys. You want to talk about it? You want to talk about it a little bit?
I don't think they were gonna. Were they gonna kill her? I think they killed her because she shot at them. She shot Krennic, I think.
Yeah, I think that's why they ultimately were gonna kill her. But yeah. He was like, "You guys are gonna come with us." Blah blah.
Did they show Death Troopers later in that movie? I feel like they could. It was kind of like a Captain Phasma thing. They're like, "Oh, we have these badass people, but we don't really show them."
Didn't they fight them in the end?
I don't remember.
I don't remember.
Yeah, I don't remember.
I don't think so.
Yeah, right. I don't think so. But it was really cool. Some of the different characters.
Yeah, I like this one. It was a very like specific to the like rebels. It was very gritty. There was some force in it, but not really. No real Jedis or anything. Yeah. So you just, again, Star Wars. This felt like the first one. That felt good. This was like the Saving Private Ryan for Star Wars.
Yeah, and especially that battle at the end there.
Yeah.
What does that guy say? I am one with the Force.
The Force is with me.
The Force is with me. I am one with the Force.
It man.
The Force is with me.
Yeah. Ip-Man.
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 This fucking guy. What was your favorite part in that movie?
So this is my number one.
We could talk about it a little later.
I love this movie.
Yeah, we could talk about it a little later still. But yeah, that was my number four, Rogue One. Yeah. You said that's your number three, Jeffrey?
It's my number three. And this actually showed the Rebels not being the good guys too. Because that, what's his name? The guy, the main guy.
He kills that
informant.
That guy in the beginning.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's like.
When I first saw that, I was like, oh shit, wait, what?
Yeah, you're the good guy.
He's a rebel.
Yeah, what are you doing?
And then even the commander was like, nah, fuck that. You ain't going to keep him alive. You're going to kill that motherfucker. You're going to get him.
Yeah. And then it did a good job of showing like the Rebel Alliance, how it was like a bunch of different groups at the end. They're like, oh, we're a bunch of people that want to do something, but we don't. But then it took the Rogue Squadron, or not Squadron, but Rogue One to kind of spark it up. So,
yeah.
They were the spark of the Alliance, the fire.
The spark of the Resistance.
Yeah.
But yeah, we'll talk about that a little later. Emily's number one.
Okay.
That
was my three.
That was your three. My three is Return of the Jedi. Mm-hmm. Return of the Jedi.
That's my two.
Okay.
Number two.
Number two. That's your number two. Mm-hmm. Return of the Jedi was very good. The climax of the original trilogy. Climax.
Do it.
That final scene whenever Luke Skywalker fights Darth Vader. It is your
destiny. Oh my God. I must obey my master.
He must obey his master.
Mm-hmm.
And he was so torn. He's like, I feel the good in you, father.
That's what she said.
Oh, Jedi scum.
It's also... Yeah, they go in Jabba's palace in the beginning.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? They're trying to free Han Solo and shit. Freaking Boba Fett is right there getting Han Solo. He got him with the fucking Samsonite. I was way off.
What?
Get it? No? Whatever. Yeah. Anyways, we'll talk about Empire a little later. But anyways, he comes and tries to save Han Solo, and he gives Jabba a chance. Luke comes in, he's like, Jabba, give me Han, I'm gonna fuck you up. And then Jabba was like,
oh, that's a good
one. Oh my god,
bro.
That was not a sound effect. That was Michael.
That was good.
Bro, fucking, he said he laughed at him and he said, "Oh, poor Jedi." Like, fucking, I don't know what he said, but he said, "The Jedi is a fucking idiot." "Here you go. I'm going to feed you." What did he feed him to?
The Rancor.
Rancor.
See, I feel like Jabba's been around for a long time, even when, like, the Clone Wars. Like, he should know Jedi are going to fuck him up. He should have messed around with that.
The Jedi mind tricks don't work on him, though.
Yeah. Yeah.
You know.
Well.
"Your Jedi mind tricks don't work on me." He doesn't say it in English. He says it in... But anyways, fucking, then they go and they're gonna kill Han Solo, they're gonna kill Luke Skywalker, they're gonna kill Princess Leia, because she comes and she tries to, like, put a thermal detonator, tries to fucking blow everybody up, and he, like, Jabba's like, "I like the balls on you, kid." Like, "I like the balls on you, kid. Go ahead, join my feast." And it ends up being Princess Leia. Han Solo's like, "What? Who is this?" "Oh, dying. Oh, dying." Oh my god. "You've been in a..."
Oh my god. "In a
chamber." Fucking, huh? How do you know? How do you know? "Because I love you." Oh. Wow. Fucking. Fucking Princess Leia. Yeah. And so they catch them. They find Chewie. Lando's over here all hiding. Freaking
in his little horn mask.
His little horn mask. Helmet. Little horn helmet. He fucking, when he nods to him, Luke Skywalker, like, nods to somebody, and, yeah, like, nobody's gonna notice that. Yeah. He did this big ass nod, yeah, to this guy with a horn helmet, yeah, on the end, and then Lando also a big ass, "Oh yeah." Yeah.
Like, it's going down.
Oh, that's the signal, huh? And yeah, they save him. They kill Boba Fett. Fucking Princess Leia chokes the shit out of fucking Jabba. She's like, "Ah!" You know?
They have a sound effect for that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Ooh.
That's a good one.
That was a good one. He's like, and fucking, they do it. And then after that, Luke Skywalker goes to Yoda. Where's Yoda located, Jeffrey?
Dagobah.
The Dagobah system.
Mm-hmm.
Gotta make a promise.
My favorite part of that movie is when R2-D2 has something, I can't remember what it is, and Yoda's just beating the shit out of him with a stick, saying "mine" over and over and over again. Mine. That's my favorite part of that.
"You must unlearn what you have learned."
Oh, wait, no.
Yeah. Crazy Yoda.
Yeah.
Yeah.
"A Jedi craves not these things."
Mm. Oh.
What are you talking about
that's
there?
Where, that's where.
"You must feel the force around you."
Oh, fuck.
That's what she said.
But yeah, Jeffrey, you want
to... yeah. With the... we'll rewind a bit. It was probably the worst showing of Boba Fett.
Yeah. Yeah. Made him look like a little bitch.
Literally didn't do anything.
They redeemed it with the show.
Yeah, but...
Yeah.
How do you... You just got hit by something. So who hit him? You got hit accidentally, I think, by Han Solo?
Yeah, they... he ended up, like, hitting his jetpack.
Yeah.
And the jetpack just, like, malfunctioned. Wow!
Okay, well, then, yeah, Yoda complete, or he complete, he, actually, he didn't complete his training.
Yeah. He didn't.
Yeah.
Mm-mm.
So,
where's I've come to complete my training.
Yeah. I'm going to come fucking 2 years later, and I'm going to come complete my training.
Dumbass.
That was a really good impression of him.
It really was. Yeah. It really was at that moment.
At all moments.
Let's hope Mark Hamill's not listening.
Mark Hamill, I love you.
I think he gets it. Yeah.
He knew.
He knows.
I was trying to do that, guys. Yeah. that was what I was going for.
I was told to be whiny.
Right.
But yet, then we just go in the battle scene, yeah? There was nothing after the training, was there? They just like, all right, there's a new Death Star 2.
Well, hey. He finds out a revelation from Ben.
What was that?
Leia's my sister.
Oh, that's right.
Leia's my sister. There is another one.
There is another. No, it goes, no. Or Yoda says that. No, there is another one. yeah, that's what he says to Obi-Wan. Or was it Obi-Wan? Yeah, Obi-Wan.
Yeah, it was
Obi-Wan. Obi-Wan. Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. But yeah, so then they go, they find out Death Star 2 is here.
Mm-hmm.
So what they got to do? They got to blow it up again before it becomes operational.
Yep.
Becomes operational.
Wow.
So... Emperor Palpatine, he's a genius.
Yeah,
he leaves it defenseless. He just leaves it.
This is the wrong third. It applies.
That was his younger days. So they just left the Death Star next to Endor, and they're like, "All right, the rebels are like, now's our time to strike."
Yeah,
but Palpatine. He formulated a plan.
Mm-hmm.
He had that hidden shield generator around Endor. Mm-hmm. And then he, when all the rebels came in, the real like Star Destroyer fleet came up behind him. And what did Admiral Akbar say? Oh my God. It's a trap. It's a trap.
I love him.
Yeah. So that's one of the best, space battle scenes.
That guy was totally Mexican.
Yeah. Super
racist. Star Wars.
Michael is Mexican, by the way.
I'm Mexican. I can say that.
Say that.
It's okay. We had a little mustache. Come on, guys.
Alien mustache.
First Hispanic in Star Wars.
You did it.
You did it.
But yeah. So yeah, the Ewoks, best part of the movie. Like, what?
I mean, I love them. They're super cute. I want one as a pet, but
do it.
Yeah.
Did you guys know the Ewoks ate the stormtroopers?
What?
At the end?
I would have assumed so. They were gonna eat everyone else.
They ate all the dead people on at the end there. That's why you saw all the stormtrooper helmets out there.
They had a fucking feast.
Yeah. I wasn't a big fan though of where they're like worshiping C-3PO.
Oh really? I loved that part.
Really? You loved that part? It just fell out of the movie. But why'd you like that?
Because he's just so unlikable in most parts.
Yeah.
And it was just funny to see that the people that liked him were these little mini bears. Okay. Thought he was some god because he was shiny.
Yeah. Gold.
I love gold.
Yeah, best space battle scene. Did you guys know? Fun fact.
Fun fact.
Straight from the movie. To kill a super Star Destroyer, you just gotta ram a small ship into the bridge, takes out the whole thing.
There it goes.
Yeah. Billions of Star Wars dollars gone.
In an instant.
I did like the new trench run, though. It wasn't a trench run. You actually went into the Death Star and, like, did you guys play Star Fox? No.
Oh, hello.
That was a loud one.
That was short, though.
It was.
Yeah.
Pretty short.
Well, this was a lot like Star Fox. You went in the tunnel and you just got lost in it. You saw all the pipes everywhere. honestly, how did they know that that hole would eventually lead to like the
they had plans
for Death Star 2?
Yeah.
How did they get plans for Death Star 2?
They probably just took the ones from Death Star 1 and blew them up.
No, I think they took plans also, and they talked about it like in the before the final
meeting
scene. Yeah.
Okay.
They did have like a holographic diorama.
Yeah, and they told them like, "Oh, this is where." Did you watch the movie?
I did.
Are we sure?
I did.
What number is this?
This is number.
This is your number three.
Oh, you my number? Were you asking what movie? Yeah, that was my.
No, the.
Oh, like the actual episode?
No. Where he had it.
That's my number two. My number two.
Number two?
Return of the Jedi? Mm-hmm. Oh, we're talking about my number three.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. That was your number two. But yeah, Return of the Jedi. Fucking amazing movie. Good.
Yeah.
Super good. At the end, I see I feel the goodness in you, Father. Mm. It's too late for me. No.
So would you guys rather see Force Ghost young Anakin or old Anakin?
Young Anakin.
Okay.
It would have, well, it could be.
It made more sense for it to be young Anakin.
Why?
Because that's the last time that
he was good.
Anakin was good. But was himself.
But he was good there.
But Anakin died with Darth Vader was born.
But he was reborn.
As
I don't know. I think it didn't really make sense because we didn't really see him as old, like
ever.
Old Anakin. Yeah. So because he had hair, right? And the old ghost had hair.
Yeah.
So.
He really shouldn't have.
Yeah, we didn't know.
Yeah, that he should have been bald.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Should look scorched.
So I guess young Anakin would make more sense.
Yeah.
Okay.
I think so. But, yeah. Fucking Return of the Jedi. Good guys win. Mm-hmm. For now. So they thought. But that was my number three. That was your number two, Jeffrey?
Yeah.
What was your number three, Emily?
Revenge of the Sith.
That's my number two.
Okay. You got Revenge of the Sith?
That was way back there.
You had it.
Five.
Revenge of the Sith. Jeffrey, I beg to fucking differ with that end fight scene. Emily, talk to him.
Yeah, no. I agree with Michael on this one.
Bro.
There's a lot of feelings attached to this fight.
Yes.
A lot of feelings.
A lot.
Okay, I can see that. I can see that.
Like, come on. Like, when Padme had no idea that Obi-Wan was in there. Yeah. It's probably Obi-Wan's fault that Padme died.
Oh, blame can go both ways, but I understand what you're saying.
You know what I mean? Like, if he would have just like went on his own, right, or like just followed her,
right,
and like came in a different ship,
right?
You know, he was there in the same ship, and he was just like right there standing, like fucking
got your girl.
Hello there.
You know what I'm saying? Like, he said that to Grievous, and fucking Grievous was like, and then he said it again to fucking, and he was just right there. And then Padme look at him like, what the fuck? What the fuck are you doing there? But that first scene also, where they're when they're in space fighting, and then they're going into that other spaceship to get Dooku. And when he fought Dooku, come on. It wasn't better than the Darth Maul fight. But it was like right there.
Oh, were you talking about the space battle or just the fight? The space battle was messy.
Space battle was pretty messy.
Yeah, it was just
everywhere. Yeah.
No organization.
Yeah, there was no organization.
No leadership.
Yeah. What were they doing? Come on, General. But fucking, that was actually. Fucking Anakin.
What have I done?
Oh my god.
No turning back now. Yeah, I just liked it for the development of Darth Vader.
Yeah.
You get to see it.
Yeah. Mm-hmm,
and
yeah.
A lot of funny memes come from that movie.
A lot of funny memes.
When he kills the Padawans.
Oh, bro.
Yeah.
That, you're going to support that? You guys support that?
Do I support him doing that?
Yeah.
No.
Killed.
Well, it's on your younglings. Top two. It's your top two. I don't know.
Oh, my God.
Three.
You guys seem to enjoy that.
Yeah. You're right. It was my favorite part.
But yeah, I don't know how you have that movie so low.
It was five.
That's low. That's number two, bro. Like for sure. It's number two. Like how that one all came together too. He's like, how can I
do it? Do it. To Anakin. Do it.
And then what else? What else did you say? What else? No, I don't have it.
Patience!
No, that's wrong. But anyways, fucking Revenge of the Sith. When the Sith finally won. That end scene where fucking Yoda fights Palpatine. Come on. Wasn't it funny when the royal guards like come up to him, they're like gonna pretend like they're gonna fuck him up, and Yoda just waves his hand and they fucking just onto the wall. I thought, but right there I guess it showed that Palpatine was stronger than fucking Yoda.
Mm-hmm.
And who the fuck was stronger than Yoda? That's why I thought Palpatine was like fucking sick with it.
Because
this fool fucking went over on Yoda. But
Yoda wasn't at his prime at that time.
He wasn't. He wasn't at his prime.
He was
already 900 years old.
He's real old.
He lost his way. He was very baffled. He's like, oh, I got punked. And he's like,
bye.
Yeah. Lost all morale.
See you later, guys. But yeah. Overall, great movie. Great movie. That was my number two. That was your number
three.
Mm-hmm. What's your number three, Jeffrey?
Mine was Rogue.
Oh, Rogue One?
Yeah, we need to do her too.
Okay, what's your two, Emily?
Solo.
Oh, she wasn't kidding.
I am not a liar.
All right, sell us on Solo.
Okay. So, what didn't you guys like about it? I'd like to hear.
I started watching it and then I turned it off because I just couldn't bear it.
What part did you turn it off at?
I don't remember.
Okay.
Well, first off, Solo is not one of my favorite characters. I'll say that right now. He's not high up there.
There are other characters in that movie.
Kind of whack.
I know. I'm just saying the main person is not my favorite.
Okay.
I don't know. I didn't really care to know his origin story.
Okay.
So, and they did the twist at the end with Maul, just dead. Did anything come with that? I don't think so.
No. Not yet.
Not yet.
A couple of years later, let's make that story. I don't know. There was just nothing. I don't know. It just, I didn't care. I just didn't care.
I thought it was cool. I liked kind of like the nostalgic parts of it. So like how Han gets his name and then how he meets Chewie. Like Chewie's literally about to eat him. Mm-hmm. And he can talk his way out of that. I think that's funny. I don't know. I just like the background of it. I liked being able to see the like crime syndicate, like Crimson Dawn, was super cool because I don't feel like I got anything like that through any of the other movies. So I liked seeing that part of it, as well as like the pirates too, because you kind of think that there's like two evils working, but then really there's a twist. But anyways, anyways,
spoiler alert.
Yeah. But yeah, I don't know. I just liked it. I liked it. I thought it was a good story, and I wasn't really expecting anything when I went to see it, which is probably why it helped that I liked it. Yeah, but I think
they did a good job with the train scene.
That
felt like that should have been in there, because it was like a heist pretty much for Solo. I'll give it that.
Yeah.
But if you asked me to name any other character from that movie, I don't think I could, besides Han Solo and Chewbacca.
I mean,
what was the girl's name?
I can't remember. What Kira.
Kira.
Her name's Kira.
Yeah.
She's cool.
Oh, and, Daenerys. That's her name.
Yeah. From Game of Thrones.
No. That's her name. She's a dragon queen.
She is. I think, I mean, Lando Calrissian's in that movie.
Oh, what's his name?
Childish Gambino.
Yeah.
Yeah. I liked his part in it. I thought it was good. His droid is funny. When they do the Kessel Run, I mean, that's iconic.
Mm-hmm.
They visit a spice Spice Island. spice mining.
Spice World.
Yeah.
Spice Girls.
Spice Planet, I think is what I was going for. But I thought all those parts were cool because I don't know. There are things that are like talked about, but you don't really know anything about it. And then this kind of showed a little bit more of it.
Right.
Which I think is why I like Rogue One as well.
Yeah.
Just because it's answering questions that I had previously.
I think it was just unfortunate that Rogue One came before this one for Han Solo.
I can see that.
Because Rogue One was really good.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, you like Han Solo, but it just... To me, it wasn't the same. I don't know.
Yeah.
Nah, I don't know. What would you hate about it, Michael?
I just got bored.
He said he only watched like the first 5 minutes of it.
I didn't even give it a chance.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
Did you? I'll give it a chance, but when I remember.
Did you think that guy that played it was a good Han Solo?
Parts of it, I do. He seemed like a completely different character.
Yeah.
But I feel like he was still kind of figuring himself out at that point. So it doesn't really show him where he ended up.
Right.
It's kind of just showing the beginnings of what happened.
How'd that end? I already forgot.
The movie?
Yeah.
You want to hear it, Michael?
Mm-hmm.
He ends up
killing the guy. Yeah.
And taking the briefcase back to the
those people
of the planet.
So he's a nice guy.
Yeah.
Oh.
And then Kira ditches him for Darth Maul. So.
Ooh.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
The Dragon Queen.
Yeah, she becomes the leader of the Crimson Dawn.
Hmm.
Yeah.
Yeah, they don't follow anything about that either, huh?
Well, I was hoping they were going to make a second movie. It was supposed to be a trilogy, actually, but then it bombed so badly that they did not continue.
Oh, that's unfortunate.
Very unfortunate.
For me.
Well, Jeffrey and I's number one are the same.
What's your...
So we'll talk about Emily's number one, which is Rogue One.
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
And we'll talk about the ending.
Yeah, it... The ending.
The best part
Michael,
of the
Michael, you can
movie.
Go for it.
No, that's you.
He was talking about it before.
That's your boy.
Your number one. This is your boy right
Darth
here.
Love Darth Vader. And this was the first time where I sat in a movie theater and I watched him light his lightsaber up and just, it was amazing. Like, I was freaking out in the movie theater.
I know. I was
just
like,
absolutely losing it.
I was like, no. Yeah. No, no. Doo,
yeah.
Doo, no. And then they played his music.
Yeah. It was, I mean, amazing. It was just amazing.
It was 20, 30 seconds.
Made the movie.
A fucking Darth Vader. Fucking shit.
Yeah, absolutely.
It's just, fucking shit up.
Yeah, I mean, that whole movie was great because he just kept showing up. I kept seeing him and I was like, oh my God, is this real? Like, he's literally on screen right now. But I liked a lot of the other characters as well. K2SO is one of my favorite droids out there.
Yeah,
for sure. He made that movie.
I love him. He's great. Jin, as we already talked about, I like her. Saw Gerrera is in the Clone Wars. So if you watch the Clone Wars, he's like very young, and I think Ahsoka stumbles upon them, and they kind of start this like little club to, I think they like dismantle some power plant on some planet.
Onderon.
Yeah. So you kind of see him in his young age. So it was interesting to see him in the movie as this old and like dying man, but still this leader of this basically terrorist group that's like trying to change the world. So I thought his character was pretty interesting, just considering that I had seen him before, and to kind of see like where his life went was interesting to me. Yeah, and then we talked about some of the Jedi Temple guards or whatever. I don't know exactly what their role was, but the guy with the guns and the blind guy.
Yeah. They put a bag over his head. He's like, oh, come on, I'm blind.
Yeah. Yeah. So I like them. And that whole movie, I really loved. It was another one of those movies where it answered questions that you had, and then they all die at the end, so you don't have to worry about sitting through another movie.
And Princess Leia comes out at the end.
Yeah.
Like, oh shit, they did that.
Yeah.
They brought back three old characters and shit. They brought back Darth Vader's right hand man. Fucking.
Oh,
It's a T.
Yeah. How do I fucking...
That's close.
Yeah. How do I feel like a shit now.
My favorite part of that movie...
Tarkin. Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah. Admiral Tarkin.
In the space battle, when they got that hammerhead spaceship that rammed the Star Destroyer, and fucking sliced the other Star Destroyer, I was like, damn, never seen that before.
Dope.
You never really see like that kind of stuff.
Yeah.
And that was cool.
Yeah. Great movie. Fucking Rogue One. But we're here at number one, Jeffrey.
All right. Where we meet.
I love you.
I know.
Oh.
I know. This little part was great.
Yeah.
Frozen in
time, pretty much.
Frozen in time. Carbonite. What was it? Carbonite.
Carbonite.
It's just carbonite, right?
Mm-hmm.
This Empire Strikes Back. Right. Number one.
Going back on that, when did they have that love thing? I feel like that came out of nowhere, no?
No, they were hinting that...
not in the first movie, that's...
towards the end of the first movie, wasn't it?
No.
No, not at all?
No, because Luke kissed Leia
in the second in the beginning of Empire, but that was just because Leia did it to spite fucking Han. You could tell.
No, I think she did it in the first one too, when they like zip lined across.
She does do that. Yeah, she kisses him on the cheek before they go.
Well, but
I think I don't know what that was for. That. That was just weird.
Yeah.
My hero. You just met this guy. And
he gets it.
Yeah. It just seemed really awkward.
Oh, okay. Anyways, but yeah. Empire Strikes.
The the battle. What is it?
Of Hoth.
The Battle of Hoth, the frozen planet. Fucking Luke goes out and gets captured. What does he get captured by, Jeffrey?
Shit, what?
The Abominable Snowman.
Yeah, but what are those real names?
What is the fucking...
I didn't know he had one.
Oh, no.
There's a...
It's our favorite fucking movie, and we don't know about it.
I keep wanting to say Rancor, but it's not the Rancor.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's...
the Yeti.
The Yeti.
I should know this.
Sully.
Yeah.
Well, yeah, he gets captured by that. See, actually, I wasn't a big fan of that.
A Wampa.
Wampa. I actually, every time I watch Empire, I skip that part.
Really?
Yeah.
For real?
It was too scary for you, or what?
Yeah.
No, it was just too slow. I didn't care about a Wampa and all really? That.
Well, do you know why they included that in?
Why?
Because he got into a car accident in real life that left his face scarred.
So he was all fucked up.
Mm.
So they included that in to have a reason for him to have a scar on his face.
Mm. Hmm. Well.
Fun fact.
They can't.
Oh. Oh. Fun fact?
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Mark Hamill got into a car accident.
Interesting.
Yeah.
Yeah. I always skip that part.
Well.
So it wouldn't have affected me.
Interesting.
I would have never noticed.
Because I don't think it was originally in the movie.
Mm.
But they, I feel like there's several things they could have added, like Chewie accidentally just backhands them or something.
Yeah.
But they went with the Abominable Snowman.
Mm. I did like the probe droids.
But Empire is where we meet Yoda.
Yeah.
Empire is when we meet Lando.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Cloud City.
Me Boba.
Oh, buddy old, or Hano buddy old pal. Don't let me down. That was in Return of the Jedi. But yeah, we find out about Lando Calrissian. We find out about, who else do we learn in this movie? I think that's it, right?
I mean, you learn other things.
We learn something very important.
Yeah.
No, I am your father.
No!
That's impossible! Bro, when you found that out, mind blown, dude. What? What? How? Who the fuck?
Yeah. Where's mama? Yeah.
Where the fuck is his mama? Bro.
Why does he not ever ask that question?
Who?
Luke. About his mother.
I think he does ask about his parents.
To who?
He just says that he never knew about his mother.
And that was Leia.
And that, no, Leia knew...
Oh, you're right.
I remember they tried to make it like a whole plot hole about like when she was like, oh, yeah, but she was just always sad or whatever.
Mm.
And he's like, oh, I never knew my mother. Or no, he asked like, what do you remember about your mother? And she was like, oh, I don't know, but all I know is that she was really sad.
Well, Leia had a mom.
She had a mom. She had a mom, but they were trying to say that they were making it seem like Leia knew the mom the whole time.
Mm.
But,
mm.
I mean, she didn't.
Interesting.
She was in Alderaan. Padme was in heaven.
Oh, Rob.
Never tell me the odds.
And then you have that fucking...
I love you.
I know.
They catch him. They freeze him. And they ship him off. To fucking Jabba's palace.
Why is he there?
Well, Jabba has a bounty out for him.
Yeah, and Boba Fett collects the bounty. He works with them, and they collects the bounty. Takes him to Jabba. Yeah.
I feel like Darth Vader would want to have the guy that shot him at the Death Star.
I mean,
I feel like he would want that guy.
I feel like he would have instantly killed him.
Yeah, it's like, oh, you. you were the cause of like the Death Star blowing up.
And then that was the first time you saw someone catch bullets like that too.
Oh yeah. Boom. Bam, bam, bam. Dude, you totally glazed over the Battle of Hoth though.
Well, talk about it.
Freaking love it.
Best battle. One of the best battles.
One of the best battles for sure. I think I would have to say it was the best like battle.
Mm-hmm.
What other battles are better?
That's a good question. Yeah, it's mm-hmm. probably the best battle.
I think that is the best battle.
My favorite, I think.
Mm-hmm.
Fucking Luke takes out that fucking AT-AT.
Just
by
throwing a grenade up in there.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Slicing it open.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
And they get belly. the big piece of string.
Yep.
Tied around the AT-AT's
yeah.
leg.
Yeah, in every game, though, you gotta just get the tow cable. Go around those AT-ATs.
Yep. Mm-hmm. Every single
game.
Every battle.
Every
game. Yeah.
You know what's funny? Big plot hole in that movie. So they're like, you know how they're flying around, they're shooting lasers at it. And then the guy's like, oh, the armor's too thick for those blasters. But then they trip it. And then they shoot it. And it explodes.
And it explodes.
I don't get it.
It tripped and something was exposed.
The armor was loosened up and compromised. But yeah, definitely best land battle, I think.
That's where we get to see Luke also in a diaper.
Yeah.
That's true. In the back to tank.
Another one of my favorite parts of that movie.
Looking like Logan. I was waiting for his claws to come out.
Yeah. Nope, yeah. He was just bouncing around in there like a baby.
But yeah, literally the rebels had no chance. Literally.
Yeah.
They
zero chance.
Nothing affected the walkers except for the tow cables.
Oh, you know, when they send that ship out to go look for Luke, do you know what the name of that ship is?
The ship to go look out for Luke?
Yeah.
Mm-mm.
It's Rogue Two.
Hmm.
This is Rogue Two. I got him. Mm. Repeat. Yeah. I got him.
Yeah.
Mm.
Huh.
I thought that was interesting after rewatching it after Rogue One.
That's cool.
Well, yeah.
They started Rogue Squadron.
That is a fun fact.
They made a whole game about him.
Yeah.
Luke with Wedge started
Wedge Rogue Squadron. Wedge and
Tilly's? Yep.
Wow.
Hmm.
Mm-hmm.
That's another.
Fun facts.
But yeah. Star Wars episode 5, Empire Strikes mm-hmm. Back, number 1. It has to be. That's the most iconic, most iconic line and scene of the whole Star Wars saga.
Yeah.
No, I am your father.
No!
We already did that bit, Michael.
That's impossible. I always thought that was super funny. That's impossible.
Oh yeah. Yeah.
And then he just falls.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Straight up
in the little tube,
and then just
it just so sucks perfect.
Sucks him in there or something.
And just hanging out outside of Cloud City.
Yeah.
On the antenna.
Mm-hmm. Which is weird because the whole reason why, here's another fun fact.
The whole reason
why Cloud City is in the clouds is because below is all gas. Like, you can't live down there. Huh. So I feel like you'd be in that gas, dying.
That's not a very smart decision to live in a place like that.
Well, no, they're Cloud City's rich for harvesting that gas. Oh. That's what they're doing.
Mm. Oh, wait. Wrong.
Huh. I thought you were going to do a fart joke because of gas.
Oh.
Yep.
But all right. That was our top 10 Star Wars movies for May the 4th. May the 4th be with you, everybody. And may the Force be with you. I am Michael.
I'm Jeffrey.
And I'm Emily.
And we love to pickle.
Don't forget tomorrow to celebrate Cinco de Mayo.
Celebrate Cinco de Mayo. And with that, we leave you guys.
Bye.
Bye. Check it out.